If you would like to create a cool effect like this, and I call this the Tesla Coil effect, stick around, I'll show you how. I'm using Adobe Premiere Elements version 13, but just about any version of Elements should work provided you have this control down here, or this effect, called Lightning. I found this underneath the render category, so just search your effects and see if you have one called Lightning. Alright, I found a neat little video here of a girl holding up, or not holding it, but playing with this leaf here. And this leaf is actually dangling by a spider web, so it just kind of makes it look like she's magically moving this thing around. Wouldn't it be neat if that lightning were between her hands? So I'm going to find a spot where the hands are moving around, and this might be good enough right here. And let's clip all this stuff off and get just the portion of the video that I think is going to be neat for this effect. And we'll just take a few seconds. I'm not going to go hog wild here and do 10 minutes worth of video here. So what you got to do is take your effect, the lightning effect, and drag it on top of your video, and it adds that effect. Now you have the motion, the opacity, and this newly added effect called lightning. You're going to get a bunch of controls in here for segment, amplitude, start point, end point, hint, hint, and all the way down to color and so on and so forth. What we really want to do is have that lightning follow her hands and not be so out of control here. So what we're going to do, and this is kind of a hard thing to stumble onto here, is that little stopwatch up there on the effects applied effects panel, you're going to click that, and that allows you to control all of these settings here at every point in time. So you can control the start point and end point along the video. So how you do that is you just click that little stopwatch button, and it's going to add a little keyframe there that says, at that point in time, I want these coordinates remembered. Now, how do you enter the coordinates on here? You can sort of play around with these things if you want to, but it's really kind of hard to do. What you're going to do is click up here in the bar, like right on the word lightning itself. While that does collapse the lightning thing, you get the drag handles at the very end of that lightning effect. So now you can take this thing and this little ball or whatever you want to call it here and move it around to various points on the kid's hands. Then you're ever going to so slightly dance your cursor around until the hands move apart. And then you're going to have to readjust where that point is. So I'm going to drag it over here. And the left one's going to get dragged up a little bit. Now notice how it adds these keyframes automatically capturing that point where the lightning is actually occurring. Now it's kind of hard to see right now because there's so much amplitude going on in segments. So let's go ahead and fix that first. Let's just change this to one single segment. That way it's a whole lot easier to kind of follow along. And let's turn the branching off. So down here, you're going to see a branch segments. We're going to take that down to one. And let's just make the width a whole lot wider so it's a whole lot easier for us to see. All right, now that we've got just some of the basics here, now we can see how the ends start to follow the hands. I missed it here. It's going a little bit too fast. So what we're going to do, I'm going to move this over just a little bit and maybe up. And you can see how it follows that that path that I just created here. Now you're going to have to do this pretty often throughout the video segment here. And it's kind of tedious, but the effects are pretty cool once you get it all done. Now depending on how you drag things around, there's these little, if you can barely see these little handles here, these little drag handles allow you to control the curvature of this to get things to go around more of a larger arc type path. And I got kind of lucky here. Well, not really. It's not that great of a follow, but it's good enough. You get the point. All right, now right around here, the hand drops down. So you guessed it, the lightning has to drop down, the endpoints. And I'm going to do just a few more here. We're not going to go crazy with this example. And you're going to see how everything sort of flows around. Oop, better bring this one in here, huh? Now, the more time you spend getting it very accurate to the hand position, the more real it's going to look. It just costs you time in setting these up. Every 10 or 20 frames or something, you got to stop it and move things around. And you can see the crazy path that we've got here with the start and end point mapping. All right, I think I'm going to do... Ooh, that's kind of neat there. She reaches way up here. Let's drag the ends way up there. And I'm guessing she's going to probably drag her hands back down. I mean, I know she does. I saw the video before. And a neat little effect where she goes all the way out here. Got the wrong one to drag. So sometimes you accidentally get these endpoints here and it messes everything up. So you just got to kind of be gingerly when you pick your start point and your end point. And Again, like I said, I told you I wasn't going to go crazy here, but it looks like I am. Just a few more. And you can see all the little edit points that I've got up on the timeline there. Actually, kind of a mini timeline. This is your key, I don't know what you call this thing, applied effects timeline. Anyway, one more, and I think I'll be done. All right, let's just play the video and see where we're at. All right, now you can see the lightning kind of moves things around and it follows her hands. And I did miss a couple spots because I wasn't taking my sweet time doing everything. But now you get the idea how you can track the motion here. Now, it might be cool to change the width, the color, the size, and everything else. That lightning looks awfully, awfully fake right there. So what we're going to do is go back down to where I changed the width. And I think I cranked it way up to 100% or something. Maybe we'll have it very, very small here. And we can turn the stopwatch on to remember that, the width. So at that point in time, it's going to be, you know, 3 units wide or whatever it is. Then maybe here we want it to be a little bit wider. Then maybe here, let's just do a real quick super jump. And then a few frames later, let's jump it back down so it has sort of like a flicker effect. And then maybe here we'll gradually go back up a little bit. Then a few frames later, we'll do a super bright one. And then a few frames later, we'll jump it back down so it gets like a kind of a flicker effect. So you get the idea of kind of what I'm doing here. And then maybe just a little bit here. Now you can play around with all of these things here, the pull force, the stability. That might be a neat one to add a lot more crazy factor to it. Maybe the amplitude, you want to turn that up a little bit. Maybe the detail level, crank it up. You can play with these things all day long here. The key thing here is how to map the start and end point with the actual hands themselves. And you can see how it's dancing around and the amplitude is changing and the width is changing, all those other kinds of neat things. The Tesla coil effect. I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching.